What is going on, guys? Tom here. Welcome back. Now, today we're going to talk about why you cannot find profitable products. Now, I know this has been one of the struggles for everybody. And if you want to know why you can't find one, and more importantly, how to find one, this video is for you guys. Okay, so let's get started. Now, before we begin, I just want to apologize that I've been away for a few weeks. I haven't been posting any content for you guys, especially in Q4. And that's precisely because of that, because Q4 was so busy for me that I had to really focus my attention on my Amazon FBA business so I can have a really amazing Q4, which has been amazing so far. And December is going to be amazing as well. So one of the things that came from this whole experience in Q4 this year is that I started to run out of my profitable products. Some of my products started to decline. And even though my other ones were doing amazing, that they actually compensated for the ones that are doing bad. But then again, like it started to kick in that, hey guys, I'm not the only one that this is happening to. So you guys must be going through that as well for Q4, where your product may not have been profitable. Now, what do we do in that case? What happens? So first of all, guys, profitable products are not found, they are created. You gotta get that concept to your mind, guys. I know that you see a lot of profitable products on Amazon and then all of a sudden they disappear. Why is that? Profitable products, just like the Amazon FBA business, is time finite, which means that if it is profitable today, by the time you bring your inventory, you build your Amazon FBA business, within 3 months, it may not be profitable. It could be like for various reasons, could be a seasonal product, could be a product that it's trending right now, but it's not anymore, right? So there's so many reasons. So that's why you gotta create your own products. And there are a few ways we can do this. Now, these are the secret, guys. So the secret to always find a profitable product is, first, you gotta bundle it. You gotta bundle it to create something new. And how do we do this, guys? So if you're selling a camera, for example, right? I'm gonna use extreme examples for you guys to make it easy to see. You're gonna sell a camera. You're gonna have a product that you could bundle it together where nobody in the market is doing. So if you're selling a product that you can actually differentiate it, then it's all about differentiation. You can actually differentiate it in a way that could almost like become a new product in itself. So if you're selling a camera, what if you combined a camera bag for it, a special one, a travel bag? Or what if you combined a SD card that goes along with the camera? Or what if you combined a mic, especially if it's a video camera? Things like this will make your product seem like a brand new product in the market, and nobody will have it there. So you gotta do your research, guys, like I always advise you guys on Helium 10. Make sure you do research to see what kind of products are available in your category. And then from there, you're gonna differentiate it and you're gonna make it better, okay? So Helium 10 again, guys, links and discount codes are in the description. Make sure you take advantage of that. And best of all, guys, free Chrome extension download for Helium 10 is available at any time at your disposal. So make sure you download that. So the first thing we're gonna do is bundle. Like I said, guys, bundle your product with something that makes sense and not something that is like a camera and a bottle. Something that is not related is not gonna connect. It has to connect with each other, and your product catalog has to connect with each other. So if you're gonna go into the electronics section, or if you're gonna go into the toys section or category, make sure your other products in your catalog are within the same category. You want the buyers who are interested in those kind of products to be upsold to. So upselling and cross-selling is a concept that a lot of companies use. So if you're selling toys, there are other toys that they could be interested in. All of a sudden, you're upselling another smaller toy to them, right? Like this bundling thing, it's an upsell. Think about it, guys. It's an upsell concept, but you're putting it together and almost giving them no choice, but at the same time creating this massive value with your product. And when they purchase it, you know that they're gonna need the other product as well, or most likely they will need. But when you bundle it like this, it'll all of a sudden seem like an amazing deal, and you can provide all kinds of like discounts, saying, okay, this product is a half price that we've bundled it with this product, so you can buy it together and save money, and at the same time you don't have to go anywhere else to. The other way we do this is by inventing our own products. And I don't mean, guys, invent the wheel all over again. No, nothing like that. What I mean is that, let's say a red cup, and Adam R. Fisher used this example. It's very, very relevant example. That's why I'm using it as well, because I think it really makes it easy to see. So these red cups that everybody buys for drinking and all that kind of stuff, right? All of a sudden, somebody found a way to make it more appealing to a crowd that don't normally buy these kind of cups, right? The red cups are more like, you know, students, anybody who's just like, who doesn't care what their glasses would look like or what the presentation of their party would look like, right? So they would buy that product. But if you're trying to serve a more higher niche or a higher, more sophisticated market, you cannot sell those red products. So what they did is actually, they made the cup clear and they put a golden ring around it to bring that class up. And all of a sudden you've entered a new market, you've reinvented the product. And you guys can do this with your suppliers, guys. Think outside of the box. Whatever product you see on Amazon that you think is profitable, you can modify that, guys. So it's all about modification to serve a higher purpose or to serve a different market that you think is gonna be profitable. And again, guys, do your research on Helium 10. Make sure that is the case before you make a move like that. Now, the last but not least way to make sure you have a profitable business or Amazon FBA business in general is to have a catalog of products. You will never make the hundreds of thousands of dollars with one product, and it's a very risky business. Never put all of your eggs in one basket, because what happens if that market crashes, if that product is not profitable anymore, if that product falls off the trend, right? Which a lot of Amazon products do. What happens then? You have another four products that's gonna supplement it by the time you find another product to put in the mix, guys. So that's why our job never stops. This is not a passive or a true passive income business, guys. You always have to be involved. You always have to be watching the market trends and doing product research to see what you can add, what you can subtract. If a product is not profitable, take it out, guys. Liquidate your inventory. Make sure that it's not eating away through your profits by sitting in your inventory and Amazon charging you guys fees and all such, right? So that's why it is so important that we don't put our eggs in one basket, guys. And like I said, guys, when Q4 hit, some of my products were doing amazing, but some of them, two of them actually went down the drain. So was I worried? No, because I had the other three products making me money. Yes, it could have been better if all five made me money, but then I lost some money in those. I quickly liquidated it, got rid of the inventory. I didn't have too much to begin with because I was not 100% sure about those products. But nonetheless, my business survived. My business is thriving because I did not just rely on one product. When you do that, guys, it's a dangerous game. But when you have a catalog of products, related products, keep that in mind, you'll be fine, guys. You guys will be golden. That's it, guys. I hope you guys learned something valuable today, because product research is one of the key things that we do with Amazon FBA, and if we do it right, that's how our business will grow. Now, one question that somebody asked me over the holidays is, why can't a product stay profitable for long? Or how long does it stay actually profitable? So, from my experience over the years, I have not seen a product to stay profitable over the 12-month period. Like, I mean, I've seen it for a year, it's been good, but you get to see the decline, like slowly it's coming. And a lot of products, they go into spurts. Business is not a straight line, guys. Business is like this, it's up and down. It's not gonna be a straight line for you guys. So that's why, like, I mean, a lot of products, some seasonal products are like within a month or two, they're gone, or even just like something like St. Patrick's Day, if you're selling a product like that, it's just for one day. In that month, people are buying that product and that's it. But some products will stay over throughout the year, like a baby product, right? Like something that's related to babies, like a bathtub for a baby or something like that, that will stay relevant throughout the year. But there are times that you will see decline. There are times that actually people are having more babies than they aren't. So that's why you see all kinds of trends happening in the world depending on the market you're in. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Happy holidays from our family to yours. I know it's not the holiday season yet, and you guys see I've already put up my Christmas tree and it's only early December. Thank you guys. I will see you guys next week, and we're gonna talk about something more relevant, which is supply and demand. So stay tuned for that video. But until then, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell button so you can get notification, and like this video. Drop your comment below. If you have any questions, drop it below and I'll be happy to answer you. Thanks again. Have a good one.